Welcome to the Kitchen Story by Vedehi. In today's video, we are going to learn how to make lachha parathas. They are very easy, very simple, and these two types of parathas are going to solve your breakfast troubles forever. So I hope you enjoy this video. Do like, share, and subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon if you like this video. Without any further delay, let's start with the recipe.
So first we will take 1 cup of wheat flour. And then we will add oil around 1 tablespoon and a pinch of salt. If you want, you can add a little more salt also, because we will not be adding salt later. Then knead properly into a firm dough. Do not use a lot of water. As you can see, I'll be using little water to knead the dough. So as you can see, our dough is ready. It is not very loose, because for parathas we want a little tighter dough. And then we will take 2 balls. I'll be showing 2 types of parathas here. First will be the masala paratha and second will be the garlic cheese paratha. So for masala paratha, we are taking kasuri methi, kitchen king masala, chili powder, jeera masala, chaat masala and turmeric. We will keep kasuri methi aside because we have to sprinkle it on the top. Now mix everything together nicely and our masala is ready. Now I will start with sprinkling some oil on the platform to roll 1 large circle out of the dough. No need to worry about the shape here, because in some time it will actually not matter. So once our dough is rolled, now we will sprinkle on top the masala that we have prepared. Since we had already added oil on the platform, we don't really need to add more oil to this. So once the entire masala is sprinkled and ready, then we will start with folding of our paratha. It's just like a paper fan or the sari plates. One by one you have to start plating it, like you can see in the video. And once the plating is done, you have to roll it tightly and tuck the other end in center, just like you see it here. Now again we will roll this into a paratha finally. Make sure that you do not press it too much, because we want those layers to be there separate from each other and not merge it. So now our masala paratha is ready. We will move on to our next type, that is garlic and cheese paratha. So here I have taken 1 tablespoon of butter in semi-liquid form, and now we are going to add 2 garlic cloves, which are finely chopped, into it, followed by some coriander leaves, that is dhania. Now we will mix this nicely so that we can apply it on our paratha. In other bowl, I have also taken mozzarella cheese. You can take any type of cheese you want. I'm not going to mix it. I'm going to use it to sprinkle on the top. So as usual, we will roll this into a big chapati kind of a thing. And once that is done, we are going to apply this butter mixture on top of it. So as you can see, I have spread this nicely and evenly on our rolled paratha. After this, we will again plate this, but before that, now we will add cheese on it. So as I told you, I have taken mozzarella cheese. You can take any type of cheese. There is no issue in it. Just top it off nicely and start layering it. So for layering, we have started plating. Since this is cheese paratha, it is obvious that you cannot have a lot of layers on it. It is going to look different than all other parathas, but it will be very tasty. So now we roll this into our paratha. So as you can see, our both parathas are ready. Now we will top our masala paratha with the kasuri methi that we had kept aside earlier, if you remember. This will add a very nice taste to your masala paratha. Just a little bit on top so that it doesn't turn bitter, but it's really tasty. In case you don't have kasuri methi, you can also use white mustard seeds. That is til, white til on top of it. On our cheese and garlic pizza, we are adding a little more cheese on top of the paratha. So now we have taken a pan, added some oil to it, and then now we are frying our masala paratha. Our masala paratha is now ready. Moving on to our second type of paratha, we place it on the pan and fry it nicely. Cheese paratha is a little delicate one, so you have to make sure that you don't break it while turning. So we are done with our cheese paratha too. If you like this recipe, do not forget to like, share and subscribe. Till the next time, take care, see you again.